Well, cast your mind back to February last year, and you may remember the excitement when NASA successfully landed its Perseverance rover on Mars.
Elon Musk and NASA share a common goal, sending humans to Mars. However, Musk is eager to accomplish this much faster than NASA. But there's a twist. NASA has stumbled upon a major discovery on Mars, and it's causing Musk to slow down his Mars colonization plans. So what exactly has NASA found on Mars? And how will this discovery impact Musk's plans? And has Elon Musk just revealed NASA's terrifying discovery on Mars? Mars, the cold and dusty red planet, has a very thin atmosphere, wild dust storms and marsquakes that shake its surface. It's been explored by humans because of its unique features. The red color of Mars comes from its dusty surface, which contains iron-rich minerals. This dust, called regolith, is what gives Mars its distinctive rust-like hue. Even though it's much smaller than Earth, Mars has the same amount of dry land. It boasts the tallest mountain, Olympus Mons, and the longest valley system, Valley Mariners, in the solar system. Olympus Mons is about 3 times taller than Mount Everest, while Valles Marineris stretches for about 2,500 miles, roughly the width of Australia. This valley system was formed by the stretching of Mars's crust and contains canyons that can be up to 60 miles wide. Some canyons have channels that suggest the presence of liquid water in the past. Mars also houses one of the largest volcanoes, which is about the size of New Mexico. It formed from massive lava eruptions that flowed across great distances and solidified over time. Across Mars, you can find various signs of water-related features, like channels, valleys, and gullies, suggesting that liquid water may have flowed on the planet's surface relatively recently. Some of these channels are incredibly long, up to 1,200 miles, and quite wide, about 60 miles deep. Scientists think there might still be water trapped beneath Mars's surface, and in a 2018 study, they suggested this underground water might contain enough oxygen to support tiny life forms. However, the availability of oxygen depends on Mars's temperature and pressure, which can vary due to the planet's rotation. Mars also has flat, low-lying plains covering much of its surface, especially in the northern hemisphere. These plains may have been shaped by ancient water flows and are some of the flattest and smoothest regions in our solar system. It's possible that the northern part of Mars has a thinner crust than the southern part, possibly due to a significant collision that happened early in Mars history. The age of these features can vary depending on when they formed. Mars has a thinner but still substantial atmosphere that supports weather patterns like clouds and winds. The atmosphere changes in density due to the expulsion of carbon dioxide during winter. In the past, Mars likely had a thicker atmosphere that could have allowed flowing water on its surface. But because Mars lacks a global magnetic field, lighter molecules in the atmosphere gradually escaped into space due to the solar wind. NASA's MAVEN mission is studying this process. It experiences unique winter weather with carbon dioxide snow clouds, making it the only planet known to have such conditions. Dust storms on Mars can be massive, driven by warm air moving towards colder areas. These storms lift dust off the ground, heating the atmosphere and intensifying the winds. These storms can be a danger to Mars rovers, like NASA's Opportunity rover, which got stuck in a large storm in 2018, blocking its solar panels from sunlight for days. And do you know, it has a longer year of about 687 days compared to Earth's 365-day, because it orbits farther from the sun. However, Mars still rotates on its axis in about 24 hours and 40 minutes, similar to Earth's 24-hour day. Mars, like Earth, has seasons because different parts of the planet receive varying amounts of sunlight throughout the year due to its tilted axis. Mars has a unique orbit around the sun, leading to extreme seasons. When its southern hemisphere approaches the sun, there's a brief warm summer, while the northern hemisphere experiences a short freezing winter. The tilt of Mars' axis changes over time, resulting in various climates. It's smaller than Earth, with weaker gravity making a 100-pound person on Earth weigh just 62 pounds on Mars. Mars lost its global magnetic field about 4 billion years ago, allowing the solar wind to strip away its atmosphere. Some parts of the crust retain strong magnetization, suggesting remnants of an earlier magnetic field. It likely has a core composed of iron, nickel, and sulfur similar to Earth. Most of its mantle resembles Earth's, but some crustal rocks may differ, possibly andesite or basalt. Basalt is a common volcanic rock on Earth and the Moon. NASA's InSight lander, which arrived in 2018, studies Mars' interior by monitoring Mars quakes and tilt changes. Ultraviolet light bouncing off Phobos strongly suggests that this moon was once an asteroid captured by Mars. Phobos is inching closer to Mars over time, about 6 feet every century. It's on a path that will lead to either a collision with Mars in 50 million years or its breakup, creating a ring of debris around the planet. Mars has been a target for exploration by many space agencies, including NASA, Russia, the European Space Agency, China, Japan, and the Soviet Union. Unfortunately, a number of spacecraft have been lost in these endeavors. The study of Mars has a long history, with Galileo Galilei being the first to observe it through a telescope in 1610. Scientists in the following centuries discovered polar ice caps on Mars. In the 19th and 20th centuries, there was a belief, notably advocated by Percival Lowell, that there were long, canal-like features on Mars that might have indicated a past civilization. Our exploration of Mars began with the launch of the Mariner spacecraft in the 1960s, including Mariner 4 in 1964 and Mariner 6 and 7 in 1969 by the United States. These early missions revealed Mars as a seemingly lifeless planet, contrary to earlier speculations about civilizations or life there, like those of Lowell. In 1971, Mariner 9 orbit Mars, mapping about 80 of the planet and discovering its volcanoes and large valleys. The Soviet Union also launched missions to Mars in the 1960s and early 1970s, but many of them were unsuccessful due to dust storms. The first successful landing on Mars took place in 1976 with NASA's Viking 1 lander, followed by Viking 2 6 weeks later. These landers provided the first close-up images of the Martian surface, but found no definitive evidence of life. In 2001, NASA's Mars Odyssey spacecraft detected large deposits of water ice beneath the Martian surface, particularly in the upper 3 feet. However, it couldn't confirm the presence of deeper water. In 2003, Mars made its closest approach to Earth in 60,000 years. That same year, NASA sent two golf cart-sized rovers, Spirit and Opportunity, to Mars. After landing in January 2004, they explored different regions of the planet and found several indications that water had once flowed on Mars. Initially planned for a 3-month mission, both rovers continued to operate for much longer than expected. Spirit rover was declared dead in 2011, while Opportunity operated until a dust storm in 2018. Curiosity rover launched in 2011, exploring Mars for past signs of life and discovering evidence of a former habitable environment in Gale Crater, along with insights into Martian chemistry and methane levels. NASA and ESA have multiple orbiters and spacecraft around Mars. In 2018, the Mars InSight lander studied Mars quakes, and in 2020, Perseverance rover launched to search for signs of past life. Perseverance is crucial for its mission to discover ancient life. It's studying a 4-billion-year-old river delta in Jezero Crater, formed by an asteroid impact, which once held a lake fed by a river. Potential signs of past life, called biosignatures, might be preserved in these sedimentary rocks. These rocks provide insights into the conditions ancient Martian life could have thrived in, especially given their exposure to liquid water, a key ingredient for life. Surprisingly, Perseverance found igneous rocks, not the expected sedimentary rocks with traces of past life. The unexpected discovery of igneous rocks in Jezero Crater hints at a lava-filled past, valuable for Mars's geologic timeline. These rocks act as time markers, and if Perseverance's core samples reach Earth, they could provide precise dates for Martian geologic events. Although our focus was on sedimentary rocks in the river delta, finding volcanic materials on the crater floor is a noteworthy achievement. Perseverance might uncover stromatolites-like structures, early hints of Martian life. Its instruments can analyze their chemical composition, but confirming ancient life will require careful study. Another potential sign of ancient Martian life is the discovery of organic molecules, the fundamental components of life which Perseverance can detect. Regarding bringing Mars samples to Earth, Perseverance holds 10 sealed tubes, including atmosphere and control samples, and 8 rock samples. While the first rock core sample initially ran dry unexpectedly, subsequent rock sampling has gone smoothly. Returning these samples is a complex task still in the planning stage, which may take years. Options include leaving them on Mars for later retrieval or delivering them to Earth through a future mission. Elon Musk believes that Starship, once fully developed, will be capable of taking humans to the Moon and Mars. When exactly is uncertain, but it can be true. What are your views on this? Do let us know in the comment section below and subscribe to our channel for more such videos. The number of craters on Mars varies, depending on the location. The biggest crater, Hellespolinitia, is in the southern hemisphere and measures a whopping 1,400 miles wide. In contrast, the northern hemisphere is younger and has fewer craters. Sometimes, just a few craters on a volcano can indicate recent volcanic activity because fresh lava covers up older craters. Some craters have unique debris around them that looks like hardened mud flows, suggesting the impact might have hit water or ice below the surface. In 2018, the Mars Express probe from the European Space Agency found something interesting under the ice in Australia planum. It might be a mix of water and grains, similar to a lake, but we're not sure how much dust is in the water. This body of water is about 12.4 miles wide and reminds us of underground lakes in Antarctica that have bacteria. Mars also has large deposits of water, ice, and dust, which seem to have been layered by the atmosphere. Many of these layers have caps of frozen water because Mars is much colder than Earth, ranging from extremely cold at the poles in winter to relatively mild near the equator during the day. On average, Mars is quite chilly, with temperatures around minus 60 Celsius, and its atmosphere is much thinner than Earth's, mainly composed of carbon dioxide. Recent estimates put Mars's core size between 1780 to 2080 kilometers. Mars has a crust about 24 to 72 kilometers thick, while Earth's is much thicker, with a mantle spanning 2,900 kilometers and a core nearly 7,100 kilometers wide. Earth's continental crust averages about 40 kilometers, and the oceanic crust is thinner at around 8 kilometers. Now about Mars's moons. In 1877, S.F. Hall discovered Phobos and Deimos, Mars's two irregularly shaped moons, naming them after the sons of the Greek god of war. Phobos can reach up to 27 kilometers in width, while Deimos is about 15 kilometers across. Unlike Earth's spherical moon, these moons are believed to be a mix of ice and rock with a carbon-rich surface covered in dust and boulders. Their origins, whether they formed an orbit around Mars or were captured asteroids, remain a mystery. Scientists from the University of Padova in Italy are actively researching these puzzling Martian moons. However, these observations turned out to be misunderstandings of natural geological formations. Interestingly, a few Martian rocks have made their way to Earth over time, providing a unique opportunity for scientists to study pieces of Mars without leaving our planet. One of the most famous examples is Allen Hills 84001, a Martian meteorite that some researchers suggest may contain tiny fossils or signs of Martian life. While this theory has faced skepticism, the scientists behind the 1996 study continue to defend their findings. The debate over ALH 84001, a Martian meteorite, is ongoing. In 2018, a separate study found organic molecules on Mars, which are the basic carbon-containing components of life, though not direct evidence of life itself. These molecules may have formed through chemical reactions similar to those in batteries. As for future Mars missions with humans, NASA aims for the 2030s, following a sustainable lunar presence via the Artemis program. The journey to Mars presents challenges, including extended microgravity and deep space radiation exposure, which can affect astronauts' health. Adapting to Mars's moderate gravity after months in microgravity is also a concern. NASA, along with countries like China and Russia, has Mars exploration plans. SpaceX, led by Elon Musk, is developing Starship, a reusable spacecraft. These missions not only quench our thirst for knowledge, but also lay the groundwork for humanity's future endeavors on Earth's nearest celestial neighbor. Elon Musk believes that Starship, once fully developed, will be capable of taking humans to the Moon and Mars. When exactly is uncertain, but it can be true. What are your views on this? Do let us know in the comment section below and subscribe to our channel for more such videos.